them is very close to my PhD subject, and I'm also very interested by all the presentations that have been done in this workshop. So my works, I will present you my first PhD paper in food price shocks on and government expenditure composition. I don't know if how to change the diapo. I don't know. Okay, just see about the outline. I will start. I will just follow this plan you have in your screen. As motivation, you know, the beginning 2000s have seen have been characterized by a major food price, a surge of major food price commodities. In all that have been due to the so many consequences that are all seed demand an increase on all seed demand from emerging countries. The dollar depreciation in other weather climatic conditions. This situation happens when major developing country are net exporters and net consumers. That is, they highly depend on the international markets for their quotidian meals. In for net export, for net producers, there are some papers that show that producer has made hardy profit, but the effect is still mitigated as fertilizer price have increased in the most important, have also increased. For developing countries, the impact was very important as of households generally don't dispose of financial and insurance tools and very limit and they also have a very limited food capacity stock. In all that have been also characterized by the increase in the import bills as their budget as they spend a very important of their budget on consumption, and that this and that food consumed is highly imports, and as the direct consequences we have billions of people that struggle under the poverty lines, and in this situation the government have to intervene in order to make household access to foods and in other society problems. So at the same time the literature have found that developing countries, particularly Africa countries, have the most instable fiscal structure and most instable, and that instability is not good for their development in other outcomes that are the essential needs for development. So in our context, we just have a question. We just ask if the structure of fiscal policy in other government intervention, in other government variables can be have been significantly affected by the food price the food crisis. So I don't know. In this slide, you just see the pattern of food price. That is here, we just select the six commodity price which according to the FAO 2009 are more consumed and more imported by developing countries. Here you have wheat, rice, soybean oils, and maize and raffinized sugar. That according to FAO, it is the meal that more contribute to food security and in the developing country. In the literature have been developed on the social economic consequences of food price shocks, starting by they made the point on the vulnerability problem and political stability that have been caused by the food or the surge of food price shocks, and particularly Ortiz and Shai, which shows that the Arab Spring movement have been accentuated because of the food crisis. And at the same concerning government expenditure composition, this thematic have been more developed in the case of political cycle in depth and crisis, and that are the situations where government generally have limit budget and just have to play in the structure of government expenditure in order to reach some goals. And concerning the stabilization tools, in general, given the government resort to subsidize and other measure in order to make food more access and more available for household. So what we try to do is to see if food price shocks have impacted that structure. In particular, you just want to evidence if the components of government expenditures that have been. Hello. Okay. So we just want to have evidence if government expenditure components that can be that must be involved in order to make a household access to food have increased during the food price shocks. So what we do is we focus on the African countries from the period 1980 to 2011. Just African countries because of the quality of the institutions and the instability of their fiscal tools and their net importance position in the world market. We use the six commodity price as we told in the first slide, and we take into account the vulnerability that, according to literature, is a very important determinant of the effect of the shocks on every country. And we don't estimate the impact of food price shocks in the total government expenditure, that are government expenditures, the total government expenditure minus the interest on debt payment, you know. And as the government expenditure composition, we didn't have a more disaggregate data on government expenditure, we just subdivide our government expenditure variable into part. That is the government consumption and the government capital expenditure. And we just take the portion of government expenditures of government consumption in the total government expenditure as our government expenditure composition. What we found is that food prices positively impact the total government expenditures, and that this positive effect is due to the increase of the share of the current government expenditure on the total government expenditure, and that this effect is highly conditioned on vulnerability. Here our data, we use data from, this is an error, it's what, 47 African countries for this time horizon. The limitation of the time horizon is due to data limitation. The dependent variables are respectively government expenditure, the total government expenditure, and the share of current government expenditure. As interval variables, you use different food price variables. Contrast variable include that, and the more important variable here is the vulnerability, that is an index construct with the PCR method. That summarizes the relevant characteristics of resiliency in the absorption capacity of each country. The source, our data are principally from FAO, IMF, and the World Bank. Here we just show how we have computed our food prices, our price choice variable. We follow Deaton and Milton, and we take import food price in the international markets in order to avoid for endogeneity that could exist between the country structure and other macroeconomic conditions. Here, our food price shocks is a geometric average of food price weight by the value of each food of each commodities in the household basket. In order to extract our food price variable, our shock variable, our shock variable is an uncertain variable. That is, for each country, we draw a regression of we regress the import food price on the time variable, and the two lack of the variable that I just mentioned one here, but it is two. It is PT minus one and P2 minus two. And from this regression, we extract the residual terms. That is our principal food price shocks. And the second food price shocks is we just compute the number of positive residual for each period of 4 years. That we call that positive food prices, and the third we just account the number of positive food prices to call that our food price frequencies. Here we just see the pattern of the food price variable that we compute in the next slide. And here we, in the first quadrant, we have the simple food price growth, and the intra-price growth, and the second quadrant, the our food price that we compute with the different method here, we see that there is a correlation, and that correlation was about 40%. Here we just see low, middle, and high, that are vulnerability level. Here we see that in the total total sample, the effect is a bit negative, whereas in the very low vulnerable, the effects are negative, but the effect is getting positive as vulnerability is getting higher. Here we just have the vulnerability. We just classified vulnerability per income group, and we see that vulnerability is negatively correlated with income level. As the model, government expenditures are generally very dynamic for each country. That is why we use. You just use a JM methods in order to take into account that the dynamic structure in order to solve into endogeneity concerns. Here, all the conditions required are satisfied, and here is the model. We just show the bias, the nickel bias that is where we introduce the lack of the independent variable in the model. So here, as a result, we see here, as I think it is very shown, that food prices positively impact government expenditures, and this effect still exists when you introduce control variables, as have been seen in the literature by many authors. Here is the effect when you use the composition of government expenditure. That is the share of government expenditure composition consumption in the total government, and the effect is as I said in the first slide. I don't know if I have enough time to continue. No, no.
You can give us a conclusion or a hint about your results within 2 minutes maximum, because you know we run out of time, unfortunately.
Okay, thank you very much. Concerning the vulnerability, then we just in this table we just show the marginal effects of food pressure depending on the vulnerability. It is found here that. Food price shocks, the marginal effect is significant from the fourth percentile. And as conclusion, the paper finds that food price shocks positively impact government expenditure, and that the effect is accompanied by the increase of the share of core government expenditure in the total government expenditure. The effect is principally conditioned by the vulnerability, and the people more affected are the poor countries, and countries who receive more order are less affected by that. So as a recommendation, we just say that stabilization report that government may involve that current government expenditure as to target poor, because the effect is seen here to be positive, but the question can be who benefits from that increase in government total government expenditure or in current government expenditures. We know that this paper is full of limitation, as we know the GMM that are more criticized in the literature, and we also expect to have more disaggregated data in government expenditures, including from the every sector of the economy, in order to be access in to reassess this impact. Thank you for your attention in your suggestions and questions are welcome. Thank you.